हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल जूलॉजी मेड इजी बाय डॉक्टर रूपाली गंज। प्लीज लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय यूट्यूब चैनल फॉर फर्दर नोटिफिकेशंस। थैंक यू।
सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी वन मोर फाइलो ऑफ द एनिमल किंगडम, दैट इज द प्लैटीहेल्मिन्स। द वर्ड प्लैटीहेल्मिन्स इज मेड अप ऑफ टू ग्रीक वर्ड्स इन विच Plati means fat and helmin means worm. So these animals are commonly known as flatworms or tapeworms, and these animals make up the fourth largest phylum of the animal kingdom. Until now, 34 species have been identified, out of which the most of the species, that is the 80%, they live as a parasitic mode of life. These species can be found in the marine freshwater as well as in the terrestrial habitats. The unique feature of their body form is that they are having a dorsoventrally flattened body, and with their body shape resembles with that of a ribbon like tape like structures, and that is why they are known as flat or tapeworms or leaf like structures. These animals are having bilateral symmetrical body, and they are triploblastic in nature. So being triploblastic in nature, yet they are acoelomate, so they are not having a true coelom, and the body space is actually filled with a space known as mesenchyme, which is also termed as parenchyma. Now the adult can assume up to a size of 1 mm to 25 meters, and these animals, they show organ level of organization, but that is lacking a definite anus. The animals are also provided with a simple excretory structure in the form of protonephridia. They are not having any definite circulatory as well as respiratory system. And for the digestion purpose, they are having a common gastrovascular cavity that is also incomplete because it does not have a proper alimentary canal system. The parasitic forms of such groups are having adhesive structures, which are in the form of hooks, spines and suckers. And the nervous system is of primitive type and resembles with that of a ladder. These forms are hermaphrodite, monoecious, and their reproductive organs are also well developed. As far as the evolutionary history of these animals are concerned, it is said that the flatworms got separated into two different lineages. One is the Atenuridae and other are the Diapetidophoras. Atenuridae is a small group which is containing only 100 to 200 number of species, and mostly the freshwater forms are included, whereas the Diapetidophora contains about 20 to 30,000 number of the species, which are having both freshwater and marine types of habitat. Among these two, rehabilitative flora has been extensively studied in terms of research, in terms of physiology and anatomical structures. For example, and the common species of this animal is the planaria. The platyhelminths are provided with some unique features, and the first unique feature is their a capability of maximizing surface area. You know, the flat shape of these worms actually helps in increasing their surface area, due to which all the cells, they come close together in the surrounding media. And because of this feature, because of this proximity, the gas exchange and the elimination of the waste product can occur very easily through the process of diffusion. So the maximization in the surface area is a big exception in terms of platyhelminths. The other feature is their unique locomotory patterns. These animals are provided with ciliated epidermal cells, which helps in the creation of propulsive forces, and their unique locomotory pattern is actually a trick to watch. The other is the cephalization, where there is a differentiation of head. So these are the first creatures to have actually a proper brain. And the structure of the nervous system resembles with that of a ladder like, and they are having lateral nerve cords, which are interconnected together by thin thread like structures, which are known as commissures. So therefore, they are also having a control center in the form of a brain. The other big advantage of this group is the simple excretory apparatus in the form of primitive kind of kidneys, that is the protonephridia, which is actually a network of tubules with ciliated structures, which are known as flame cells. If you look into the microscopic examination of the protonephridia, they are provided with ciliated cells, which helps in drawing the interstitial fluids from the body cells and helps in the reabsorption of these cellules, which are returned back to the body. So therefore, they are also having a simple type of osmoregulatory system. The power of regeneration is one of the best features of platyhelminths, because they can recover, they have the power to recover their damaged body parts which have undergone any fragmentation accidentally. So if either the anterior end or even the posterior end get defragmented, they are having the power to regenerate both the ends, whether it is the posterior, whether it is the anterior. And the whole organism can grow up to a period of about 10 to 12 days. So if they get fragmented also, yet they are having the capability to transform into an altogether new organism. Parasitism is again one of the keys of the success of platyhelminths, because most of the platyhelminths live a parasitic mode of life. So parasitism is actually a negative interaction in which two participants, they participate, one is host, another is the parasite. For parasitism, for being successful parasites, they have undergone various adaptation in the form of the the hooks and suckers. Hooks and sucker helps in various purposes like adhesion, scratching, irritation to the intestinal wall, and these can draw their nutrition from those blind areas as well. So tapeworm is actually one of the best studied examples of the platyhelminths, in because they can reside in the body of an adult individual for a period of about 20 to 25 years. So parasitism is again one of the unique features of platyhelminth. Reproduction can occur by both asexual and sexual methods. Asexual helps in the formation of the genetically similar individuals, whereas the sexual reproduction results in the formation of genetically different individuals. The phyla of platyhelminths are divided into three classes: Turbellaria, Trematoda, and Cestoda. Turbellaria is actually a Latin word in which actually means a string. Now these forms are free living forms and are mostly are aquatic. The body size ranges from few millimeters to 50 centimeters. They are provided with a cilia, which again creates some propulsive forces, so they can move very well. And they are also having mucus secreting glands, which are known as the gland cells. They don't have any proper hooks or suckers, but still they can serve as predators, sponges, commensals, or even parasites. They are also hermaphrodite, and the examples of this group are the Gyratrix and Planaria. Then the other class is the Trematoda. Trematoda includes the form which has the feature of hole making forms. Right, so the forms which can invade by making holes inside the body tissues. So these are parasites, whether they can live as ectoparasite, they can also live as endoparasites. So their body shape is cylindrical or leaf shape, and their body is covered with a thick covering of cuticle. They also are having suckers, and their digestive system is very well developed, and they are also having the protonephridia for the excretion purpose. The best studied examples are the fasciola hepatica, commonly known as liver fluke, and the schizostroma, that is the blood or lymphatic flukes. The last class of the phyla platyhelminths is the Cestoda. Cestoda forms are exclusively endoparasites, and they are having very well developed organs of attachment, that is the hooks and sucker. As if we see the scolex of the tapeworm, we are having the double rows of the hooks and at least four suckers. Now these structures help in the attachment, adhesion, and various other purposes for the animals. They do lack a proper mouth and a digestive tract, and they are hermaphrodite. Their life cycle is complicated. Life cycle is complicated means they require two or more hosts, because they show various stages in their life cycle, and for that they need multiple hosts for the formation, for the completion of their life cycle. The economic importance of the platyhelminths lies in big in terms of medical parasitology, because the parasitic forms are responsible for various diseases, and therefore the discoveries of various drugs and vaccines have actually helped the mankind to overcome such kind of diseases. So their economic importance is well attributed to the field of medical parasitology. So I hope you are able to understand the various characters about the platyhelminths. Please like, comment, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.